Well, I've been here 14 hours. Should I start? Ben? You have the machines on, Ben?
Everything's rolling.
Put the pipe away. Rest my ass. So I guess I'm pretty known for a fat sound on the guitar. I used to be a lot fatter than this. But the key to a fat sound is you gotta play fat. How I play fat, I only play with these two fingers. I never really learned how to use these. And They're pretty worn. I don't know if you can see that. This pinky is, it's like a virgin. It's never been used. It's got arthritis now. But what I try to do is stretch as much as I can out of one note. I'm not really good at playing fast, although I can. Just using these two fingers. I try to stretch as much as I can. And as you can see, I'm using two Marshall amps and what looks like a Fender Vibralux. It's not really a Fender Vibralux. Fenders to me are for cars. But what we did was we had this amp reworked by a guy named Ken Fisher, and it's called a train wreck. And what I do is, to get that sound really fat, I got an octave that I run through it. It doesn't go through the Marshalls. It's got its own separate distortion, and I try to separate them with a box. I'll show you the boxes later. There's an A-B box on the floor. A is for ass, B is for butt. The Marshalls have a pretty solid sound by themselves. So when I add the octave to it, you can hear it underneath. It's like a subwoofer. Notes out of one note. I get very excited when I hear I was a little kid, maybe 2-3 weeks ago. I think I must have been 8 or 9 or something. I went to my aunt's house, and my cousin went to Juilliard, and she had a ukulele. And I started fooling around with the ukulele, and ukuleles only got these, what they call the top four strings, D, G, B, and E. And a week later, she sent me a ukulele. I think it was a Martin uke, and that's all I did. Was played that ukulele. And my grandmother's brother was one of the writers for Jackie Gleason. And he was my hero, Jackie Gleason. He wore $4,000 suits, carnations. He just looked great. Never rehearsed, just like myself. But she took me to see a show. And the announcer got up and said, due to the summer, Jackie Gleason's gonna be replaced by Tommy and Jimmy Dorsey. It was called a stage show. I was so depressed. I was crying. I wanted to leave. But in live TV, you couldn't leave. You had to wait. Couldn't get up and walk around when they stopped tape. And when the guy announced that Jackie Gleason was going to be there, I mean, I couldn't believe it. And then he said that tonight's first guest was going to be Elvis Presley. Well, nobody saw Elvis before. When I saw him, that was it. I wanted to learn to play the guitar. So my mom took me to this guitar school in Hempstead, Arthur Murray Dance Studios, and I ripped the fat strings off the guitar because I only played the ukulele. And the next week, my mom went to find out how I was doing, and the teacher said, I think you better take him home. So I had to talk, you know, everything I learned, I had to teach myself. And she had the bright idea to enter me into this talent contest on the radio. And I sang Heartbreak Hotel, and I lost to a little freaking tap dancer. Now, I don't know how you lose to a tap dancer on the radio, because all you're gonna hear is, and I lost, and I was crushed. But that didn't stop me. I started to learn how to play the guitar my own way. And I tried to simplify it, because I couldn't play fast. I couldn't read. I didn't even know the chords I was playing. I played very few chords, and to this day. But I play a lot of inversions of chords, and I can take an E minor. Very few things have a lot of fingers going on. And then I drop the strings down and get open tuning. First guitar was a Stratocaster I got from my bar mitzvah. I wasn't so thrilled with it. So when we started Mountain, my partner Felix had given me a Les Paul Jr. It wasn't this one. This one was painted. But this guitar was a Les Paul Jr. It's basically just a hunk of wood with a microphone on it. It was the cheapest guitar that Gibson made. And the pickup on it is called a P90. And the P90 is actually a single coil pickup, but it's wired so hot that it was pretty much responsible for the distortion that I got. And I still use the guitar, and my friend Larry DeMarzio had made me a pickup called Mega Drive, which is this. It's a combination of a P90, and it's about as much volume as you can get without losing the tone. You don't want to lose the tone. Because, like I said before, I don't play fast. I only play with these first little finger. But what I try to do is get as much out of it as I can. And even at a clean sound, you can get pretty good tones out of it. The effects I use are basically simple. I got a garage full of stuff, but these happen to really appeal to me. And there's one that makes a guitar sound backwards. So if I go down the neck, it goes up. Instead of up, it goes down. So I try to incorporate that into some of the stuff. And then I got a compressive delay on it. About the most complicated song I know. This is a theme from Imaginary Western that was written by Jack Bruce for us. And I only know about four or five chords. I had to learn these. Thank you. can really play like this. It's just different inversions of the chords with descending bass line. Myself. My mom took me to Arthur Murray Dance Studios in Hempstead to the guitar school, and since I played the ukulele, I ripped off the two fat strings. I didn't know what to do with these fat strings. And the next week, my mom came and asked the teacher how I was doing. She says, I'm afraid you better take your son home. And I wasn't depressed, I just wasn't getting that. So I really taught myself on the four-string guitar. I had a tenor guitar, which is just the last four strings. So I played a lot of two-finger chords, three-finger chords. I never learned how to play the... So I really taught myself the best way that I could learn. I hear guitar players tonight that can... play rings around me, but what I tried to do is take the few things that I did well and try to really, really do them great.
Hi, I'm Howard Stern. I'm a disc jockey scum in New York, and it is my great privilege to be on the Leslie West. What is this, Leslie?
The MTV's Headbangers Ball. Coming up, videos from Def Leppard, AC/DC, Mountain. Who the hell is Mountain?
Mountain had quite a few songs besides Mississippi Queen. One of them is called Nantucket Sleigh Ride now. And Nantucket Sleigh Ride is from the whaling days when they throw a harpoon into the whale's ass. And the whale would get pretty annoyed and he'd go down as far as he could go into the water. And he'd come up roaring mad and he'd take the longboats on what's called a Nantucket Sleigh Ride. And the sounds, I used to listen to whale sounds. The sounds that the whale makes when he's angry, and even when he's talking, they sound like they're from another planet. So I tried to recreate that on the guitar. And this guitar is made by this company that I have called Westberger. What my friend did was he bought all the inventory from Steinberg, and we redesigned the guitar, took a little of the shape of Eddie Van Halen's guitar, and put a trans trim on it, which makes you be able to change the key while you're playing. Three steps down, three steps up. And it stays perfectly in tune. I like to use this for Nantucket Sleigh Ride because I can get it to sound like a whale. This is what the whale sounds like.
Thank you.
tune-up section. And on this section, I'm going to show you how I tune up. I don't tune up like normal. I mean, you got the E, A, D, G, B, E. That's where the harmonics are. But what I try to do is there's a chord in the middle of the guitar, some kind of version of an E. And if I tune the chord to being in tune, it seems it's in tune everywhere else. You have an open E octave. So you got three E's. Seems to be in tune everywhere. Everywhere I go, it's in tune. Sometimes on the guitar, you play a chord on the second fret, it's out of tune up here. I hate out of tune guitars. I hate out of tune guitar players better. Now, when I'm tuning up, I get tired of the regular tuning, so I drop the strings down. I drop both E's down to D's. Play blues like this. And you gotta tune it up again, because they don't stay in tune good when they're this low. You got the open E string and it's tuned down low, so it makes it a real great seven. Take a couple of minutes and explain how I got my vibrato and show you how I play Mississippi Queen. First of all, the vibrato is the same kind of vibrato that violinists use. It's a tremolo, but a lot of guys have fast ones. I've got a real slow one. Hendrix had a slow one, Eric Clapton had a slow one, Eddie Van Halen got a slow one. And believe it or not, it's the same technique as jerking off. The hand is just like this, but it's on the neck. And I try to do it as slowly as possible. And when I stretch the string, but I bring it back and forth from the original position. Like if I'm stretching this string, I try to bring it back to the same position that I was in when I started. If you do it like this, it sounds too impatient. So I try to bring it back to the original note. This is the original note. use that, believe it or not, in almost every time I touch the neck. Single notes, chords.
Mountain were kind of like the original American heavy metal band.
Mississippi Queen, one of those songs that no matter, I don't care who you are, you have to love that song.
There's no hard rock song which has more impact than that. Mississippi Queen, if you
know what I mean. So in Mississippi Queen, the riff is this. Also play behind the beat. If you notice, I'm playing it slow, but if you play too fast, you can't get that same feel. Try to answer each lick with another lick. Try to use and stretch as many notes as I can out of one note. Like if I'm playing this, instead of doing it, I can do this. I play a lot of open chords on the first three frets. It's much fuller. That's much fuller than when you play up here. Stretch this to an E. Thank you. chords of the song. It's just E, D to E, and then G to A. Can't get much simpler than that. And then when it goes to the change, A to B. You know she was a dancer. She moved been on wine. Well, that's them dudes was making them bad. Brother, beg your pardon, I was getting mine. The same technique and Never in My Life, which was another mountain song, had a riff in it. It was in G. I'm stretching notes two frets before the note. I can get a G out of an F. Serious, it's just like jerking off. You gotta do it slow. You grab the back of the neck and you pull. And you pull until you squeeze every bit of it. Even on the high string.
Thank you.
This is basically the control room. This is where the stuff gets recorded on tape. We've got tape machines over there, and then we put it onto a DAT. And then they press the CDs. These are all the outboard effects, harmonizers, delays, compressors and stuff. And this is the actual board. We'll come in here in a little while and I'll show you how all this works. But follow me this way. I want to show you some things about the studio. Keith Richards was here a couple of weeks ago. We'll call this here. Eric Clapton, myself. And as you can see in here, they gave me my own room with my picture. I think it says, got the best engineers here, but the worst girls. I don't know what girls are talking about. We have these rooms called ISO booths where we put the amps when we don't want them to be leaking into drums and stuff. They're double doors. So it's pretty soundproof. And there's amps in there, we put mics. And there's all kinds of doors in this place. We got another one over here. Oh, look what comes out of this door. Where'd you guys come from?
What?
Came from an alley, Russian? I want to show them what's in the book. Let's follow you back into the... These are like assistants in the studio. We happen to have a nightclub right here. When you get tired of recording, you come here. What's your name?
Barbara.
What?
Barbara.
Barbara?
Yes.
Barbara. She's Russian.
Brazilian.
Brazilian? Oh, okay. What's your name?
Yes.
Very good. Pretty soon they're going to be famous, right? Most studios don't have this. But selling points of this studio, you come in here and you get a lap dance. These guys are really excited about it. Barbara tunes my guitars when she's not dancing. So this is a... interesting guitar. This is a Casio synthesizer guitar. Howard Stern gave me this guitar. He used it on one of his shows when I was a musical director. And what's really interesting about this guitar is that it sounds like a lot of things but a guitar. You can make it sound like a guitar. But more than that, you can make it sound like an organ. A couple of octaves on the guitar. This is a high one, low one. And what's really unique about it is if I stretch a string, I hit the chromatic and then it stretches in increments like on a piano. We used to have this song called Long Red Mountain, and the beginning was played on an organ. And since we got rid of the organ player, the pain in the ass, and I figured out a way to play the part on the guitar. Song, but have a song called Theme for an Imaginary Western, and it sounds pretty good. We didn't use strings on the original, but... Bruce wrote that during Cream, and it was about Cream going on the road when the wagons leave the city and for the forest further on, the sun being in their eyes was the fame and stardom. And Eric Clapton didn't want to do the song. He thought it was a little too complicated with too many chords. They were really blues oriented, but the solo itself in that song changed my life, because there's a pentatonic scale. Even though I don't know how to read or write music, it's sort of like a minor or major scale. In other words, when we did that song, it was in the key of A. So when it came time for the solo, if you just play in a regular A position, it's not gonna work. Because I was playing minor licks. So my partner, Felix Pappalardi, who's no longer here, his wife shot him. Oh, by the way, don't ever give your wife a gun. Very important. So the pentatonic scale, to me, meant absolutely nothing. I don't know anything about music, but it was explained to me that if I'm playing A major, every key has a relative minor. The relative minor in A is F sharp minor. So if I play the solo as if I'm playing a blues in F sharp minor, it fits. Tried to figure out every relative minor in every key, in the key of G. Instead of playing the, like if you're gonna play a blues solo, you go to a G bar position. Doesn't really work. It's a major that fits over a minor chord. Over major too. changed my life because usually you go and play a bar chord. When you're gonna play a solo, you stay right in that position. Now that's the relative minor to A and the fifths. Also country and western too. We had a song called Silver Paper that went like. Also, there was a song called Raunchy. It's all based on the major and minor scale. A lot of the chords that I play are neither major nor minor. Like in A, I just play the third. Here's a major, here's a minor. But I can play. Most of the stuff is all based on these first three frets. They're all open chords. And I don't know if you can follow my fingers, but it's still just these two fingers doing everything. This finger right here, very important finger. This finger, what are you laughing at? I use this to push. And this pushes this finger up. So I get a lot of power. If you just use this finger by itself, it's not gonna hold. If you use this
Scene 7, take 1, marker.
Ow! Damn! This guitar is a sort of like a junior. It's got one pickup. And Washburn made it for me. We're trying to make it like a Les Paul Junior. And the idea is I wanted it to be the biggest, fattest, baddest sounding guitar. And I'm going through the control board here. There's no amps. And they got this special box that makes guitar sound really fat. Listen to this.
Thank you.
Compression. Compression happens to be this is without compression. If I add the compression, you can feel your balls are up. Listen. So I basically thought that after playing a guitar for 10, 15 years that I'd be selling insurance or women's underwear or lingerie, but there's something about this that still gets me excited, and maybe you can find something in this tape that gets you excited. Somebody once asked me, the president of a guitar company, what would I do if I was running the company? And I'd say I'd give guitars to everything on the face of the earth, women, children, adults, even monkeys. Because I think it's easy enough that a monkey can learn to play it. But I really hope I see you down the line on the road, in the studio, you buy the CDs, buy the tape. But most of all, play the guitar or play some kind of music. Because it's the only thing that keeps me going. Thanks a lot. Go fuck yourself.